Because you know you want to have that crazy, like, thumbnail face. Okay. Hi there, Internet. It's been a while. I've been busy. Part of the time busy just relaxing. But back on a new production now. I wrapped up my work as a designer and supervisor of too many departments on Officer Family. And I believe they're a little past halfway through the season for animation now. So, looks good so far. I've seen a couple episodes, rough cuts. It's going to be cool. It's going to be a cool season. So now I'm on a new show. Not sure how much I can talk about it, so I'm not going to say anything yet. It's more kid-oriented. But that's about all I'll say. And then it's sci-fi, which is interesting. It's a weird kind of sci-fi. But science fiction, so lots of interesting concept art and design. Right now we're in the pre-production stage, so get into a flow. When I was on F for the last little bit there, it was full production, so it was very fast, go, go, go. Taking a bit of a mental shift to get used to now being... Let's double check to see their sound over here, by the way. Yes, good. Now being in development mode and coming up with ideas, and there's a lot more spitballing, less tight parameters on what we're doing. So that's good. That's ultimately going to be good, but at first it was a bit of a mental shift of getting used to like not having as clear-cut set of instructions on what to do. But that's cool. That's the job. Gotta be flexible. So I'm gonna work on this thing that I left off last time. I don't remember if I did this in the last time live stream, but it's been a few weeks since I worked on this page. It's more A Bastard's Tale. It's my memoir. And I did do some of this today before logging in, kind of getting into the mode before I had to run some errands. There's a figure I want to add to this panel. So I think I'll do that now. Which layer it would be on? I think. Behind that one. Yeah, so let's put it there. Bring a new layer. Ooh, I got too many unnamed layers. Let's name upper layers. That's something you should always do. I usually do, but this one press the work. Oops. I don't want capped. Ooh. I got this mini keyboard, which I quite like, from Epoch Maker. Except for the fact that my hands have still not gotten quite used to the fact that it's mini. And there is a marked shading. Here. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. I don't know if you can hear little voices. I've got YouTube on and my headphones here, so I can hear. So, what's new with you guys? There's only currently one viewer, so what's new with you guy? Anyway. A little bit of a problem off to fix.
Hello, everyone. I'm Amy. Welcome to the Mystery Bank. Where we talk about all things.
What shirt did I have myself wearing in this scene again? Just opening a JPEG reference. Nasu. I don't know what that means, but I'm going to assume it's hello, hello, ho. With my comments. Where's my image? Did it not open? There it is. Well, that's not the one I want, though. There we go. Okay. I gave myself the collared Western shirt that I used to wear. I draw myself with pockets. I have pockets in that shirt. I did. Okay. And I drew them. One of the fun things about working on F is that it was set in my childhood time period. We had an interesting conference with one of the producers, and they were talking about how a lot of people working the show weren't even born when F takes place, but they can still appreciate the humor and weirdness of the times as an artifact historically. But for me, it was much more direct echo of what things were like when I was a kid. Not quite as much cursing in the circles I ran, but, well, you know, actually, easily as much cursing, just not at me. A little less parental abuse going on in my immediate circles, although, compared to today, it was still pretty rough. What kids are used to today? So, in case you're wondering, the aesthetic of this book, sorry, this story, could eventually be a book, going in an anthology actually, is very sketchbooky rough. So I'm intentionally keeping really scribbly and using rougher tools for my finishing, my inking, Mixed media look. It was done with watercolor and markers and pencil crayons and stuff. Some of the earlier pages were actually done analog, and that's exactly how they were done. And so I'm maintaining that modality for my digital tools. A little darker. I think I want to throw in some textural noise. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is make that
figures show that the Sukhani
looking at some old pictures of myself. I'm going to find some good reference to sketch my profile from when I was a kid. Where are the truck photos? Just want to put them here.
Thank you.
shape's a little off, but the general lines aren't so bad, so I am going to use a mesh transform. I don't think... Oh yeah, you guys can see the mesh. Good, good. There we go. Yeah, did my jaw stick out quite that much. Let's do better. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Well, a bit of work done. Let's get to figure in. Saw me doing some finishing. I think it's a good time to call it. Keep this video short for a change. I do a lot of long ones. This is a short one. A little sketching. I'll probably keep this very loose like that as much as I can. In keeping with the style of the story. But then I have to go in. I'm going to use different layers to flush out the interior of the truck. I have some reference for old abandoned trucks. And see if we can't wrap this page up tonight. That'd be cool. Be a bit of a late one, but you know. Check out my Instagram if you want to see further progress. I'll post it there. This is just a little taste. And a reminder, I do have a Patreon. So currently, I've been suspending payments on Patreon, so I'm still paying. I back other people on it too, so I'm still paying out, but I'm not collecting. You can join the Patreon, patreon.com/salgood, and you get charged the initial first for joining. I have it so that it charges right away, but after that, you're not gonna pay any, and so consider that a payment to read a big ton of comics that you get to download for free right away. All my self-published independent stuff is up there as a big archive library pinned to the top of the patrons only thread on the blog, and it's like an excess of 400 pages of comics on my Therefore Repent and Dream Life and my Revolvers, and then a whole lot of work in process stuff, a lot of the Dracula comic, by the way, Dracula Son of the Dragon. If you back the Kickstarter, keep your ear to the ground, your eyes on your mailbox. The print editions are finally coming. So it's been available for digital for a while. It was on Comixology. It is on Comixology. And if you can pick it up there if you want to right away. And Comixology was going to do a print edition. And they still technically are, but there were some problems with their print solutions. And long story short, they're going to go with Dark Horse. So it's going to be a Dark Horse / Comixology publication, which is cool. I've never had a book with Dark Horse, I don't think. So that'll be a new one to add to my belt. I have mixed feelings about Dracula. It took way too long to do. It's not the perfect book I wish it could have been, but it's some of the best art I've done in my career. It's subjective a little bit, but I think I put a lot of time and energy into that part of it. It's the beginning of a larger narrative that I know Mark Sable, the writer I was working with on that, is my collaborator. I co-wrote with him. He's got a continuing story arc to do about young Dracula's evolution into Vlad the Impaler, and eventually Vlad Dracula, Prince of Darkness. But our story just covers his youth. And the print edition is coming in September. So if you're a backer, it'll be showing up in the mail. Keep an eye out for it. Make sure that they have your current address. I'm not handling it, so don't talk to me about it. I'll go to the Kickstarter and contact Mark and make sure he has your latest postal information. If I owe you art, and there are a few, not a ton, but a handful, sorry. It's some of it's in, you guys can't see right now, some of it's hanging behind me. There's a two or three pieces I have left to do and then to pack and ship it. Those of you whose work has already been done, none of it's been shipped out yet. Sorry. Crazy busy. New animation jobs kind of filling all of my time. And what little I had, I've been greedily keeping to myself for either just relaxing or doing this work. But I have to sit down and do a big bunch of packing and getting stuff shipped off. I'm terrible at that. I definitely decided that I'm not going to be doing any more art commissions without some sort of third-party shipping scenario set up, because I don't want to have to handle it. I take forever to get around to it. It's not intentional. I just have a lot going on, and it's hard to remember to schedule time and sit down and do it. And I like to do it right. I don't want to just rush it off or slap it in something so it gets destroyed on the way. So it takes a little bit of time and attention. I'll probably be posting about the new job occasionally, or more like talking about it occasionally, euphemistically around it, because I can't really talk directly about it a whole lot. But again, part of the reason I've got the Patreon payments and suspension is that I have a full-time job in an animation studio where I'm a props designer. At the beginning of the mention of the video, I mentioned that I just finished work on If It's Your Family on season 5, and for that I was the props designer and then the supervisor for props and characters and effects. I'm taking a break from supervising now, so I'm just a props diviner for this new show. Props diviner? That's an interesting noodleism? Spoonerism? Okay. Check out the links in the doobly-doo, and I will see you around the internets. Keep on doodling. Cheers.